fits in one of these categories, but I'm going to let you make that association. For me, this is a lens for continuous improvement. Okay, so I've come over time when issues occur and put them in two categories, okay? One category, those things can be solved within the current context, and those where the problem is the current context or the structure, right? Now, I didn't think about this way, but sitting here this week, I realized these are special cause episodes and these are common cause episodes. So I want to talk about some examples about how we learn to deal with these using PDSA and things along that line. So this is an example of data. It could be from almost any hospital in the U.S. It would be a little bit different because in 1905, or about there, Medicare said to hospitals, we will pay you a certain percentage, 2 to 3% of your Medicare income, if you collect and submit this data to us. It has to be accurate, and we're going to share it with the public. Okay? So if we just take this line, this is antibiotics for people who come into the emergency room with pneumonia. Performance, 50% to what we thought was the best practice. Now, it's not that they didn't get antibiotics. Most of the time, they were getting antibiotics that were more potent than they needed, which has then the unintended consequence down the road in terms of the resistance, and that's why the most resistant bacteria in the U.S. now either live on farms from all the antibiotics we give to animals, or they live in hospitals. All right. So, what did we do? Okay, so we come from a tradition, professionals, a lot of training. We obviously have to educate people. Right? So we did that for a while, and lo and behold, we're actually not getting a lot of results. So we're doing this at the same time. There is actually an abundance of literature that shows education does not change professional behavior. And I will define the operational definition of education because there are a lot of educators here. And my definition would be a little bit like taking a bucket of water out of a river and saying, I got a river. This is just a very specific example. So on this axis, this is the method to intervene, and this is the result. On this axis, the number of studies. I mean, there are over 100 studies, all right? And you can look, high was only 30% of the professionals changed their behavior. Almost all of this was done on physicians, a lot of it on residents. And what you see is didactic classroom and informational mailing blast facts, emails, all that stuff, has very little effect on changing professional behavior. On the other hand, if you do audits, feedback, prompts, reminders, you can be much more successful at changing behavior. So what we were using was didactic and informational only. And the didactic would be a one-time thing. I mean, it could be 5 minutes, could be 20 minutes, could be, yeah. So that was sort of, when I saw that paper, that was like a little da moment for me because I had had a lot of experience trying to get people to stop smoking, alcoholics who fell with cirrhosis to stop drinking, people that are overweight to actually stop the behaviors that create the overweight. And just to show you, this is a picture of what's now called NASH, non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. It's the most common cause of liver disease in the U.S. at the present time. Any physician, you show this to the average physician, they could not distinguish it from alcoholic cirrhosis. And it turns around, if you feed animals high doses of concentrated fructose, corn syrup, this happens in their liver. All right? So, if we were completely rational, we would respond to logic. But we are not. And we're attached, as I showed you in the juice experiment, to our behaviors. So, what I began to realize is what we were doing and what we did is the education didn't seem to work. So this bloke was probably here, backs out, was in the water. So you get a truck, more education, you get to fix the problem, right? And lo and behold, water. So what do? You get more education, right? And lo and behold, you get the car out, and then you try to get the other part out, and lo and behold. So I now have this slide that when I go and present data, and I did this to a group in the spring. Last time I did it was probably about June. And each year, the physicians that have care lines and that, they come up with what they're going to work on, and they usually find a problem, and there's usually conversation about, we've got to educate the physician, and I rain on their parade and show them this kind of stuff. So we've got to the point now where we understand education is necessary to create awareness. It's not sufficient to change it.